what's going on, everyone? It's Chris, and welcome back to some more Wolf Among Us. In the last episode, we found out that Crane has a snow fetish. And we don't mean the white stuff on the ground. We mean Snow White. Now, I don't know why. I mean, he's a creepy old man. So, I don't know why he has this... I guess we don't really know why we're attracted to anything. But... nonetheless, we need to figure out how he's behind these murders, because he seems pretty guilty right now. Before I start, just kind of want interesting note, I doubt you guys care, but I used to record by PC games with Fraps, but I'm trying out OBS for the first time, so hopefully this might, I don't know if it will improve the quality, but nonetheless, it'll just make things 1,000 times easier for me. To play games, so we'll see what happens. Alright, so let's go ahead and click the magic play button and start episode 3. The only downside to recording through...
oh, to be so they're simple. Right.
Sorry, man.
We had a beginning, a middle, and an end. But ever since we moved to this awful city, everything's gotten so confused.
Look, I didn't kill anyone.
And I'm supposed to just believe you. Snow. I just want you to be careful. I almost lost you once, and...
I'm not yours to lose. I'm not going to be an errand girl for Crane anymore.
She looks like Holly.
It's not Holly. It's her sister, Lily.
She was looking to pay down debt. Eventually, the only people she owed were at her work. You know, that shithole club, the pudding and pie.
My name is Narissa.
Well, Narissa, I've got some questions. The open arms.
Oh my God! What is it?
It's Crane.
Crane? What is he up to?
That motherfucking piece of shit!
Crane? Ugh. God, you think you know a person. Bigby, you have to tell her.
I know!
What's going on? What did you find up there?
Crane's the killer.
What? Ichabod Crane? How do you know?
Shit!
Crane's been... Oh, Bigby, calm down. Everything's going to be fine, okay? It's going to be fine.
Will someone please explain this to me?
Crane has been stalking Snow White. The room is covered in evidence. Where did you see her last? Did she say where she was going?
She took Holly to the business office to prepare for the funeral.
Lily's funeral?
Yeah.
How do you know?
I was just at the Trip Trap, and I heard Gren telling some folks about a funeral at the Buckingham Bridge.
Trip Trap? Are you drinking?
When?
Right now. They were on their way out.
Bigby! Wait.
What?
Snow's been through a lot. There are things she doesn't talk about. Just please be careful when you tell her.
I know.
No, you don't know. You know how you felt when you saw that picture? Well, it's going to be much worse for her. Just remember that.
Thanks, beauty. Alright, well... oh god, he's going to the funeral? What? That's not a good idea. They're all gonna hate you there. Why do you think this was a good idea? Just stay out of the funeral. No, everyone's gonna think that it's your fault that she's dead.
If you're here, then you were part of a very special circle. People she trusted and cared for. I won't offend you by claiming one day that the pain of losing Lily will ever subside. I know as well as you that it will never subside.
I'll miss worrying about you.
That the memory
I'll miss our
of Lily
fights.
Will sustain
I'll miss
well.
You.
And it
Holly.
Will, in time, equal in strength to our mourning her loss. And it is in that
now
spirit
you will
that
never
I'd like
die
to talk
from
about
indifference
what you've
or
all
lead
been
a
so
tedious
grateful
life.
To share with me.
Goodbye,
your
sweetheart.
Of her.
Thanks for
how
everything.
She could be stubborn
Vivian.
And patient, rash and thoughtful. How she carried a torch for the old ways,
you
for
were
tradition,
a big, bright,
for
shining star
pageantry.
In this shithole of
most
a town.
Of all,
and
it
I miss
seems
you already.
Lily loved. Dearly loved her friends and family.
Sad.
She loved being around them, in good times and bad. I never met Lily, but from what I've been told, I know in my heart that she would have liked to be here tonight. And now we'll have our moment of silence. Thank you.
Well, I'm not gonna interrupt. I feel like that would be way too rude, and hopefully I don't have to interrupt to continue the gameplay, because that would
Bigby,
suck. There you go.
Is everything okay?
No, not you.
Holly, it's...
He wasn't fucking invited.
Holly, wait.
He has no right to be here. Not after what he did. You throw my sister down the witching well, and you have the nerve to show your face here. After you lie and say you'll check first.
Holly, wait. That was Crane. Just Crane. He disposed of Lily's body before Bigby could do anything about it. I'm telling you the truth.
Don't cover for him.
But this genuinely wasn't his fault.
Crane's a fucking prick, so this doesn't surprise me.
Hey, what do you know? We actually agree on something.
Bigby cares, Holly. He's trying to help. And I'm sure he has a very good reason for being here. But this one isn't on him.
Why are you here, anyway? And don't say it's because you care about this.
Everything okay?
I'm here to talk to Snow.
Oh, really?
Yes, Holly. This is serious.
Okay, look. Bigby and I are going to have a little chat far away from the ceremony, all right? Look, Holly, I know how this must...
No, you don't know how this must feel. You have no idea. Don't fuck anything up. Don't bother anybody. And when the first sign of trouble comes, and it will come because you're a goddamn walking trap for it, I want you the fuck out of here.
Of course. I won't even know I'm here.
Let's just continue, okay?
This is such total fucking bullshit.
Let's go, Holly.
It's your turn to talk.
This better be wildly important. It's been hard enough making a connection with these people. When you pull this kind of stuff, it just resets the clock.
Lily was Crane's prostitute. I followed a lead to this shithole motel, the Open Arms. Crane had a room there, and he's been taking prostitutes, or at the very least Lily, and making her look like you while he was, you know.
This is... I don't even know what to say right now. I really don't. I'm just trying everything I can right now to not picture it.
I'm sorry, Snow. And I'm sorry I had to be the one to tell you.
You're sure this is what happened? This is what he's been doing? Because please, Bigby, don't confuse things. Deposing Crane would be the next step. You took a cab here, right?
Yeah.
I'll drive. Snow? Narissa? What is it?
I'm sorry, but Holly's asking for you.
Are they starting the burn?
Yes. Everyone who spoke should really be present for this part. She's kind of distraught. You're not leaving yet, are you?
2 minutes. I don't mean to be,
No, I understand.
No, I get it. Take your time.
It won't take long.
And I feel like something bad's gonna happen.
How'd it go? At the motel? Did you find anything?
I did. It helped a lot. Thanks.
Narissa!
Yeah, coming!
Bye, Narissa. He's just gonna be standing there.
Constable?
Knew it.
Wait, easy.
Knew it.
Girl.
You knew it. Scones. God damn it. Why?
You say, how do you do? How do you do? That way, it's proper.
I'm not gonna say anything. I refuse to give these guys attention.
We'll
snip even though they have to.
Chase for old sakes. A little bird told us that you're fitting to go after Crane. And you see, we have an interest in that particular boy. So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone. Just take a little vacation is all. Don't even have to go anywhere. Just sit in your office and whistle to heaven for a few short days.
You're trying to pull this shit at a funeral? We can deal with this later.
No, not later. Later's too late. Right now. So what's it gonna be? We have a deal? You leave Crane alone, and we leave you to yours? Brother, speak your mind. Fastly now. What's it gonna be? Always wanting to do things the fun way.
Ladies, gentlemen, invertebrates, please, rest easy. This is not...
What the hell is going on?
What's happening?
Very sorry to impose, but we only had a deal to work out with Bigby. And we're unhappy to report that things did not go as smoothly as planned.
Bigby, what is he talking about?
Never you mind that. It ain't any of your...
What deal? They want me to leave Crane alone.
Crane?
Oh, now you shouldn't have done that, old boy. Really. That wasn't right, telling everyone our dealings.
Oh, shit.
What did I tell you? What did I say?
Holly?
You think you motherfuckers could come here uninvited? You think you could just fucking interrupt Lily's funeral?
Calm down, darling. It was just a simple business transaction.
You fucking freaks are not getting away with this.
Holly, don't move.
Yeah, listen to your lady, love.
Holly, let me handle this.
Yeah, let's spare all the fuss. It's just a dead hole.
I'm gonna kill you!
Holly!
Jesus.
I got it, Dan!
Shit. Goddamn. Okay. This is quite the funeral. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Is she dead? I called it. I called it. I knew something was gonna happen. It was not gonna be that easy. Damn it. Jesus Christ. This is the first episode that, like... I mean, I think I played it once, and I don't really remember it that much. So maybe that's how I knew that something bad was gonna happen, but... This is gonna be the first episode that I really... have no idea what's happening. Episode 3. crooked mile. A crooked mile, rather. Not crooked. Crooked mile. Not doctor.
I did as well as I could to take out the buckshot, but there's still some shards left embedded in your shoulder. They'll eventually worm their way out on their own, but until they do, you're going to be sore.
Bigby, Dr. Swinehart was appointed Fabletown physician for a reason.
It's okay. There's only one thing you have to take away from all this. Take it easy. Don't go looking for any more fights. Sorry. Keep strain off your heart. And try and get some rest.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm good.
Is she?
She's fine, Bigby. I had everyone that got wounded sent home. Holly refused to let me see where she lived, so I left her and Grendel back at her bar with a dose of juniper and spring water. Just remember what I said. The stitches won't hold up if you continue to act like you normally do. Everything in moderation. And eat more chicken.
I'll try to.
All right then. Very good.
Good guy, Wolf.
Business office.
That's the persona I'm trying.
I know.
Still.
I'll have to call you back. The town is starting to find out.
Well, I'll leave you two to it then. Miss White, Bigby.
Thanks, Dr. Swinehart.
Keep on thanking people in this game. Very thankful for the life I'm given.
So, to recap.
Crane watched me through the magic mirror uncover his room at the Open Arms, and then he smashed it so we couldn't use it ourselves to go after. We know this because Bufkin was drinking in the rafters. That about cover it?
And once he puts all the pieces back together, it'll be easy to catch Crane. So, I guess that's the plan, currently. But I don't know.
There's no other leads. This is it. Just wait for the mirror.
Yeah. What the hell is going on? Just, I don't know what the Tweedles get out of this. I don't know if Crane sent them. I don't know if... I mean, this is gonna sound crazy, but do you really think Crane did it? Everything points to him. I get it, but do you really think he killed those
I'm not
women?
Sure, but I feel
confused
like
as you are, to be honest. I don't know.
I did say he was in front of Beauty and stuff, sense. Which was a bad idea, but I thought that was angry.
He was
anger
a conniver,
that was
a
giving off.
Coward. A liar. And I'll always hate him for that. And I'll hate him for how he held me in his thoughts. But murdering prostitutes? Ow! Everything okay over there?
Yes, Miss White. I just cut myself on a piece of the glass. Nothing to worry about.
Thanks for tonight, by the way. That could have gone really terribly. I mean, even worse than it did.
I just feel bad for Holly, really.
Yeah. Time heals everything eventually. At least, I hope so, for her sake.
I feel like they're never gonna like him.
Can
like
I,
Bigby.
Ask
I think
you a
just
question?
Bitter like that.
It's kind of personal.
Oh.
And I don't want to offend you.
Sure.
It's just... when stuff hits the fan, like it did tonight, it feels like before we came to the city. It feels kind of like home. And I've heard it said that maybe in some tiny little bottled up way, deep inside, you kind of enjoy it when things go wrong. Because it gives you an excuse to just, you know, stop pretending. I guess it doesn't matter.
Guys? We have a problem.
What is it?
I can't finish the mirror. It's missing a piece.
What do you mean, missing a piece?
Yes, it's,
Bufkin, are you positive it's not here? Maybe it just slid under one of these cabinets.
No, I'm sure it's not here. I checked every corner. I saw Crane pick something up after he smashed it. I'm sorry, I didn't realize what it was until now.
Well, the mirror can't work unless it's whole.
Well, that's not entirely true.
Or what, Bufkin? What? We sit around and wait until it mends itself? We have no idea how long that will take. We're just gonna have to do this the hard way.
I'm just saying, waiting is an option.
No. We can't depend on the mirror.
What exactly is the hard way?
We'll look through his things, his desk, everything. He had to have left something that tells us where he's going. He's a neat freak, but he was never that smart.
Smart enough to take a piece of the mirror.
Very true.
We can still solve this ourselves. I know
never
that
never mind that. Come help me look.
Alright. WSAD. Here we go. I like games like this where it's mostly just kind of like a movie. Where you don't really have to do too much, like, walking around, battling. I mean, there is fighting a lot in this game, but it's not like you have to actually control the character. You just have to press buttons. It's really freaking easy. You just enjoy the storyline, which it's games like this that I enjoy. What's hard for me, though, is, like, playing, wait a second. Dear Mr. Ichabod Crane, I am writing to ask again that you please send someone to fix the air conditioning in our unit. Okay, that's not really anything. That's a freaking air conditioner thing. Okay. Yep. Mr. Crane, you said you paid to have the planter redone in my building after the last incident in 2004. It's falling off and the fucking off the fucking walls. Please fix it. I can't rent out that room as it is, and I've already been waiting for days. Not to mention you already promised me you'd send someone to fix the big crack in the glass in the front door. Well, guess what? It's worse now. Get your shit together, Mr. Toad. Oh, Toad. Are there any updates on the extra funding I requested?
Did Crane ever do any work?
Only when Cole was around.
Who's Cole? Oh, is that the mayor? Jesus. Hello there, Buck. What's with, like, the weird-ass smile? It's just, like... I don't... They just smile at each other as if this actually is meant for something.
There's a page here that was torn out.
Oh, yeah? Bufkin, do you know what was here?
The king...
It's a ring, at least. Every magical item not retained in the armory is assigned to someone in Fabletown. It must be this witch he is going to see.
Witch?
Wait, what? What witch? What meeting?
He called up somebody. He said he needed to see his witch, or that he would need to get to the witch for that.
Bufkin.
Whoever that is. Well, yes, it sounded like the one he got his,
Bufkin.
New glamours from.
Bufkin.
I'm sure it's about this ring. They must have it.
Why not mention this before?
Yeah, really.
No one asked me.
Bufkin.
Bufkin.
And I'm hungover. I'm sorry. They set the meeting at 2 a.m.
Bufkin.
Tonight.
What's going on? Is the mirror fixed yet?
Bluebeard,
oh,
this
God.
Isn't the time.
Not
is the mirror fixed or isn't it? You called
I
me to...
I called just to see if you knew where Crane could be, and that was it, okay? And I'm sorry I said anything more than that.
Well, you did, and I know. The cat's out of the bag. So, can we find the dull pervert or not?
I tried...
No, it can't be fixed. It's missing a piece.
This is none of Bluebeard's business, Bigby.
None of my business? Crane's the murderer. He escaped. Seems he spoiled your every attempt at locating him. And now it's none of my business?
We don't know if he's the murderer.
Oh, please. Of course he is.
Look, this just isn't the time. He took a piece of the mirror, so we can't use it.
The only thing we know is that Crane's going to see a witch at 2 o'clock.
A.M. or P.M.?
A.M.
Listen, Bluebeard, you're not a part of this.
I don't think you're in any position to turn away help.
Why do you even care about this?
Why? I'm invested in this enterprise we call Fabletown. Literally invested, since it's mostly my money that keeps the whole thing running. And tonight I hear that Crane has been killing fables, and there's no system in place to catch him?
Look, we know that Crane is going to see a witch, and it's to acquire a magic ring.
What's the ring?
We don't know what it does or who it's assigned to since Crane tore its page out of the book.
This farce was your ridiculous idea for a plan. I mean, who put you in charge in the first place?
Fixing the mirror was the most logical
thing. You're a secretary. He's the sheriff. And none of you were chosen to run this office. Who elected you to make these decisions?
Nobody, but that
doesn't... Who elected her to spend my money?
Well, I've been doing that unofficially for years.
Snow can obviously handle this, so let's drop it.
Well then, excuse me for having the Commonwealth in mind.
Bluebeard's a fucking asshole.
All right, let's just look on the bright side. We know Crane is going to see the witch that's been supplying him black market glamours.
Thanks to me.
And that he'll be there at 2. So that gives us a few short hours to find out who it is and where they live and get them all at once.
And a few shorter hours, the more you babble about it.
We haven't been the ones babbling.
2 a.m. Piece of cake.
Since Lily used the glamours, she'd have known who the witch was. And I don't think Holly's burned her things yet. It would probably have the address or a phone number or something.
And Bigby is free to go there if he likes. But I think the question you should be asking is just what do the two Tweedles know about this?
It doesn't matter what they know. After tonight, they'd never go to their office.
They're not smart enough to try and go anywhere else.
The Trip Trap is the better option to track the witch down. That has to be our focus.
If Holly has Lily's things, that'd probably be the safer bet.
I don't really care what you two do. I'm going to his apartment.
What? You can't just go up there.
And why the hell not?
We already looked for the key, remember? I don't know where it is.
Then I'll pick the blasted lock. I've wasted enough time waiting for the mirror to find him. I won't waste any more.
You just can't go up there alone, all right?
I've no interest in nicking his drapes, my dear, if that's what concerns you.
What concerns me is you traipsing through possible evidence.
Oh, now it's evidence.
Bluebeard, you're not going anywhere.
Really now? And what? You gonna stand here and babysit me while the rest of your leads evaporate into mist?
We have to find the witch, Bluebeard, since that's where he's going.
Or the sniveling weasel chickened out. Never went anywhere. And is upstairs right now in his pitiful penthouse, crafting a fort out of couch cushions. Look, this is how a smart person would do it. So this is how we're going to do it. Wherever you go, I'll go to the other.
I don't like you going anywhere unsupervised. He's up to something. I don't know what it is, but we don't have the time to really worry about it now. Where are you gonna go, Bigby?
Oh, decision time, nice.
So you leave Crane alone, and we leave you alone.
I'd love to join you, but there's some business I need to attend to.
No, I'm better off dealing with things alone. I don't need sympathy and I don't need charity.
I have no idea. Time is ticking, yes. Tick, kicking. Time is kicking. Alright, I think I'm going to
Holly's.
The witch's
identity must be with Lily's stuff.
Oh god.
See Holly first.
Perfect. And I'll go to
desk just pushed in.
I'll check in with you later. I hope you know what you're doing.
I hope so too. Yeah, let's hope for the best, because I have no idea what's going to happen.
She's asleep, you fucking idiot. We're closed.
Guys, it's me, Bigby.
Hey, look, Woody, it's the sheriff. Well, come on in, buddy.
Grant.
What? He's a traveler. A weary traveler in search of some hospitality, right?
Yeah, sure. Thanks.
Ha want a drink. Anybody else want a drink?
Grand, oh, again.
Swinehart said you shouldn't mix
you
it.
You think I give a fuck what that fucking guy says? Or what you say?
Grant, really, you shouldn't drink right now.
I can't hear you when you mumble.
Have you seen Lily's things? What wasn't burned at the funeral?
Is that stuff supposed to be here, or...?
Nope, haven't seen it.
Molly's asleep in back, but you won't be able to wake her.
Really?
The doc gave him both barmesidal ambrosia for the pain.
Look, the deal is, if you resist going to sleep, like I am right now, it gives you a very, very, very nice high.
Oh my god.
And he said that he shouldn't mix it with alcohol.
This guy's gonna just overdose. He did tear off his arm, but he's gonna overdose.
Let me tell you something. I haven't felt this good in a long time.
I said those two things together.
And I feel like having a drink, okay?
There's no way to wake her up.
Oh, no. And anyways, the doctor gave me strict orders to let the fine woman sleep. She's had a very traumatic experience.
I'd assume as much.
That funeral back there? That was a shitty fucking send-off for a pretty okay lady.
Yeah.
You weren't fucking there. Talking to Bigby now, okay? Can't say you being there helped things much.
No.
Bren, don't start nothing.
Who's starting anything? I'm not.
You think I shot up the place? It wasn't my fault.
They got away, though, didn't they?
They did. Well, you're right.
Whatever. It's all right. I'm too out of it to get into it. I want to clear the air. We're all in this dung heap of a fucking shit town together. We're all gonna have a toast. All of us.
Fellas, I'm here for one thing. To look through Lily's belongings and get out of here.
Now, yeah, right? Yeah, I know. And I want to help you, okay? And I will. But first, indulge me. It'll take 2 seconds. As a show of good faith. And after, we'll all hunt and peck for Lily's shit or whatever.
Grand Bigby didn't come here to get loaded with you.
I don't want
to
get loaded with him.
I'm running out of time, Grand.
Enjoy your drinks, fellas. I'm not being one with you guys.
Gren, the doc said you needed to rest.
How many times you fucking gonna warn me about it, huh? You're not my fucking mother, so just get off my back.
I said I was sorry, all right? I can't do anything about it. It's done.
Oh, Jesus.
What more do you want? What else can I fucking say here?
What is the problem here? What stupid shit will you both not let go of?
Oh, I forgot. You haven't heard the news. This walking lard cake was paying Holly's sister to let him fuck her behind all of our backs. And Holly had to find out going through all of her sister's shit. What fun that must have been. Trick after trick of this fat ass and Lily.
I didn't plan for that, all right? And our thing... whatever it wasn't a big deal. It wasn't. I never fucked her when she was snowing. I didn't know nothing about that.
No, but you knew Holly would flip out. And you knew for a damn good fucking reason.
You know what? Fuck this. I don't need this shit.
Oh yeah, that's it. Now you're teary-eyed. You were always such a lowlife. I don't know why I never realized it till now. What do you think about this fucking loser, Sheriff?
He can think whatever he wants. I don't give a shit.
No, that's okay, because I'll tell you what he thinks. He thinks you have to pay chicks to touch your fat, hairy
ass.
Don't
speak for me.
I think whatever happened was between them, and Lily is dead. So let's put this whole thing to rest, Gren.
I feel bad for the woodsman. Like I do. That's why I didn't really go after him initially.
Grin.
I don't know where Lily's shit is. Check Holly's room, I don't know. But I wouldn't wake her if I were you. Sleepwalkers and trolls. I think that's the rule.
Thanks for the...
Actually, Bigby, if you'll excuse me, it seems that I'm gonna pass out. What a day. Am I right, Sheriff? What a fucking day.
Grant won't remember that. I don't know why I found that so funny. That's fantastic. Grant won't remember this. Oh, man. Alright. Alright, so. So let's not wake her. Lots of alcohol. Oh, Jesus. Okay, well. I guess that does not have anything to do with that. Oh, hello there, I guess. Hi. Grab. Alright, so there's a lot of things. Oh, my. Uh-oh. She's awake.
Is that you, Woody? Woody?
No, Holly. It's me, Bigby.
Bigby. Bar's closed. And excuse me, but I'm not in the mood for entertaining. But what the fuck? I know you're not gonna leave. You do what you want. You always do what you want.
You're welcome. Alright, what's this? They all have... That was
do you even give a shit about us? The strays? The ones that aren't in that fancy high-rise? Those of us that gotta work for a living.
You may not believe this, but yeah, I care about everyone who came over.
I don't know about that, Sheriff. You're friends with your friends, and we ain't friends.
Well, I'm sorry about that. There's a lime or two.
Why'd you even come here? There's nothing here to investigate. I can't be any use to you.
I need to, look through your sister's things.
To look for clues?
If you want to put it that way.
Is it, well, no, that's basically it. What's that?
Be honest, Sheriff. Why are you going after him? The guy that killed Lily. You could have quit a long time ago, but you're still going. Why? Did they give you this job for a reason?
I'm doing this for Lily. She deserves whatever justice I can get her.
I'll take it.
I'm trying.
Uh-oh. If you were getting your glamour on this day, then one of these has to be the witch. But, which one?
Hello, this is Snow White calling. I'm looking for Bigby. Is anyone there? Bigby, if you're there, pick up, okay?
Snow?
Hey, I just wanted to see how it was going. Did you find anything?
Just an address book with her contact's initials. Not sure which one is the witch, though.
Strange. These people keep cropping up. Before, a few days ago, I thought I knew everyone in Fabletown.
Hey, did you know that the woodsman was sleeping with Lily?
Like, a customer?
Yeah.
Okay, is this really important right now?
I guess not.
You should try going up to Crane's place. I sent Buffkin up there to check on things. Bluebeard, you know. Or you could try at the Tweedle's office. Just make it quick. We don't have a lot of time. The meeting is at 2.
I don't know. I think Crane's apartment.
Over to Crane's apartment. See what I can find there.
Sounds good. Just keep me posted. In the meantime, I'll see what I can do on this end.
Okay.
Good luck, Bigby.
We'll find him, Snow.
I hope you're right.
I thought bringing out the woodsman would be important because he's still, like, kind of there. You know, he was a suspect. He kind of still is, but... Hello.
Bluebeard burned everything. I tried to stop him, but I got here too late.
He burned
everything? He wouldn't listen to me. Threatened to strangle me if I got too close.
It's not your fault, Buffkin. I should have come here first. Didn't think Bluebeard would mess things up this badly.
Well, that sucks.
Something here I could use to find him. There isn't now. What a waste of fucking time.
What now? Did you find any information about the witch at the Trip Trap?
Just this. I don't know which one she is, but to start, maybe I can find more at the Tweedle's office.
It's worth a try. I'd better go fill Miss White in on the circumstances. She's going to be very disappointed.
Good luck.
Oh God! And now I think we're at the Tweedle brothers' place, and that sucks.
Excuse me.
Oh, hi, Sheriff Bigby. Great to see you. I don't know if you remember me. I've seen you around, but you may have forgotten.
I know who you are, Flycatcher. You worked at the Woodlands for how many years now?
I think I've lost count. But you know, Crane let me go recently.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I mean, it's no big deal. So, what brings you here? I mean, can I help you with anything? Are you here to see one of the brothers?
I was hoping to have a talk with Dee or Dumb. Do you know where they are?
No. They don't really keep regular hours, as far as I can tell. Sorry. It's been a quiet night so far. I think the twins are out, probably working on a case. Sometimes I don't see them for days. They gave me the job after Crane told me to get lost. He said I was just in the way.
Where's their office?
Oh, right this way. I was going there next anyway. I can let you in if you want. You can wait for them there.
Sure. Thanks.
No problem.
He's a good guy.
I'm gonna have to take a look around.
Well, I guess that would be okay.
I wasn't really asking for permission.
Right. You're the sheriff. I just don't want to get in trouble or anything. I'm sure it's fine. I mean, they never told me not to let you in.
Don't worry. I won't get you in trouble, all right?
Right.
At least I'll try not to. Who knows what will happen. Hello, cigar box.
You know about this?
No.
Dear Brother D, I think we should get ourselves a dog. Sincerely, Brother Dumb. He actually mailed this?
They do have their quirks.
This is pointless. Dear Brother Dumb, I hate dogs and you know it. Sincerely, Brother. Freaks.
Freaking idiots.
I know these guys can come off abrasive at times, but they aren't so bad once you get to know them.
They're weird as hell.
They care about helping people. They're kind of loud at times, but you get used to it.
How do you mean they help people?
They're detectives. Anyone can come in here with a problem and they'll do their best to fix it. The way Dee explains it, it's like if someone lost their cat, well, they could hire them to, you know, track it down. Or like sometimes they get packages for people. They can be like couriers, you know?
For who?
All kinds. Come to think of it, I don't really know where they keep them. Anyways, I'm just saying, you just don't know them like I do.
Sure, yeah. Flycatcher.
Yeah, no, yeah. You're right. What else? I mean, I saw files over here that I kind of want to look at. But there's nothing that's hovering me there. Aha! Hello there.
Let's see if they got a file on Crane. Ichabod Crane. He owes the Crooked Man money. Shit. How is he planning to pay this all back? Request for property acquisition, further details filed under Donkey Skin. Crane hired them to look for a photo? Why did he want it back so badly?
Donkey Skin.
So that's why they were at her apartment, and the woodsman's place.
See, I knew you wouldn't find anything. Anything of interest, anyways. They're detectives, like I said. Just trying to make an honest living.
I haven't found anything yet.
I'm just saying.
Look, just trust me on this. Tweedledee and Dumb are not nice. They're not helping anyone.
Well, they helped me.
Okay, great. They helped you. That's one person. Now, please, just let me concentrate here.
Yeah, really. Brannigan. Who's Brannigan?
Detective Brannigan. Keep an eye on her.
Oh, that's right. That's right. I forgot about that. Back out.
Find anything?
Not what I need.
What if you're wrong about them?
I'm not.
They're misunderstood, sure, but that doesn't mean everything.
Oh my god, Flycatcher, you were a good guy, now you're just obnoxious.
I mean, you know, like when I think about it, you guys aren't that different. You help people, and they help people. Not that it's any of my business, but I just wanted to say, you know, give him a chance.
I'm just not gonna say
people
anything.
People can surprise you. Bigby?
Shit. There's something here. I know there is. There has to be.
Why would there be anything
because
to...
Because they're lying to you, okay, Flycatcher? That's why. They aren't detectives.
Bigby, what happened to your...
You want to know what this is? This is them showing up to Lily's funeral with fucking shotguns!
I'm sorry. I didn't know.
Look, Flycatcher, I know you like them, but they're a part of whatever's happening here. They're bad guys. I didn't mean to...
There's a door behind this file cabinet. I don't know what they keep back here, but it might be what you're looking for. Well, that key you found should work.
Thanks, Flycatcher. God damn it. He looks like a stoner. Alright, let's look at the package here.
Hold for BCW.
What are you looking for exactly? Maybe I can help.
Anything about Crane or the witch he was using? Something. J.D. A book.
Yes, this, that is a book.
Didn't really tell us much.
Alright, let's look up here. I don't know how far into the episode we are in.
I'm sorry.
Oh, no, I know. Late. Never mind.
I'll get it to you soon. Ichabod Crane.
Who was he sending money to?
Crooked man. Care of the Lucky Pawn. You know what that is?
I'll take the money.
Is that what you needed?
I don't think so, but it's interesting. There's more going on here. I still need to find that witch, though.
Alright, before we go any further, I'm just going to end it off today's episode because we are 51 minutes in, plus. So thank you guys all so much for watching. Hopefully we'll conclude on a high note for episode 3, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.